just shadows.
If you're a teenager now, I doubt you knew us.
We are your uncles, your angel grandfathers, characters in a play.
We are the ghosts of the remaining older generation.
If you're a teenager now, you might not know the way we died.
It's the living part that mattered more, anyhow. It wasn't that long ago, was it, when so many of us got sick?
But these are the stories from your life.
And ours.
All we ask is that you remember the way we lived and died.
It's 8:43 on a Friday night, and Cooper Riggs is in his room, alone, feeling nothing.
I know those eyes.
Yeah, the eyes that reflect the flat, dull world he's been living in for so long. So what does he do?
He gets online, of course.
And why not? He's only 17 now, but online he can be anything. Anything anyone needs him to be. He has fake profiles, photos and imaginary histories, and he fills his conversations flirting with men, making promises he'll never deliver on.
Small sparks in a lifeless world, I guess.
Just playing at life.
We remember that, don't we?
Feeling our body wasting away. Drifting away, lying in rooms alone, feeling like nothing. Yes, we do.
It's 9:03 on Friday night in a town called Kindling, an unlikely place for a blue-haired boy named Ryan and the pink-haired boy called Avery to meet.
Prom night.
Look at them file in.
There's a little bit of everything here. Boys in tuxedos with flowers, torn hoodies, boys in ties as skinny as their jeans, V-neck t-shirts, boys who feel awkward wearing dress shoes, and girls. Girls wearing the colors of the rainbow.
There he is. The pink hair gives him away. And look at that. Sure enough, the blue-haired boy walking toward him. They came with other people, but that didn't matter much anymore. They dance and don't care about anything else besides each other.
Magical.
I know how they feel. Like the supernatural is natural, and wonderment comes from the most mundane moment, like a heartbeat or a glance.
Possibility, the hope, the naive belief that love can show up in surprising little moments.
Oh.
It's 10:45 on a Friday night, and Craig Cole and Harry Ramirez are at Harry's house making final plans for their record-breaking day. What record? They are going to break the world record for the longest kiss. 33 straight hours.
We are excited for the kiss tomorrow. We don't see how they can do it, but we hope they will.
Couldn't do anything like that in our day, could we? Who knows? No one ever tried.